Hello, my name is Eric Heyer. I'm the commercial product trainer for Daktronix. And today we're gonna show you how to properly install the Ethernet fiber communication option for Galaxy GS6 display using the Daktronix hosted Venus Control Suite software. The objectives today are to show how to properly mount the comm box, how to properly mount how to properly install the media converter inside the display, how to connect it to the network, and verify that everything is hooked up properly. Here's the equipment that will be sent with the Ethernet fiber communications kit. We've got our fiber Ethernet comm box with a media converter inside of it. We've got our fiber cable that'll be actually supplied by the installer or by the customer. For the purpose of this, we just got a short little one that we'll be connecting for our video here. We've got an Ethernet cable. We've got our media converter for inside the building, as well as a wall pack transformer that'll be connected to it as well. On the media converter that is at the building and the sign, you'll notice that there's some dip switches on the side here. On the top of the box it says config switches and it has 1 through 6. It's important for the GS6 display that you change dip switches 1 and 3 to be down. From the factory they will all ship up because there are some displays that require all the switches to be up, but for the GS6 we need to make sure that 1 and 3 are down. So go ahead and use a little screwdriver to knock those switches down, and I'll do that now. So I'm going to hit 1 and 3, and that's set up for the one inside the building. You'll need to do the same thing for the one at the side. When mounting the Ethernet fiber comm box at the display, we generally request that you mount it to somewhere on the structure as opposed to the display itself. However, we know that that's not always possible. So if you're going to need to mount it to the display instead of the structure, we just ask that before you start drilling into the display that you check behind the modules to make sure you're not going to be drilling into any electrical components, the controller, anything like that. Generally, if you're mounting it to the side of the display on the cabinet, you're going to be pretty safe. And so what we're going to be doing right now is mounting it to the cabinet right here. Once the comm box is mounted, you'll want to take the ends of the cable and plug them into the back of the display again. There are two cables. Our Ethernet cable here will plug into the top port. And then we got our auxiliary power cable that'll hook into the port right below it. Once you've got the comm box mounted and it's plugged into the display, you'll need to then route your fiber cables into the comm box. You can route that through a knockout in the bottom of the display, and you can hook up the fibers, whichever color you want, into RX and TX. So I'm going to hook the red into TX. And the black into RX. You can see we've just finished mounting the fiber cables and setting those in. They are locked in, so if I pull on them, they're not going to pull back out. We've got the red going into TX and the black going into RX. That's important to remember for when we get inside to the other media converter. Now I'm at the other media converter. Normally we would have the fiber obviously running from the sign underground in some conduit and into the building. For the purposes of video, we're keeping everything pretty close here, but it's the same general concept. At the media converter inside the building, we need to hook up the fiber cables the opposite the way we hook them up, so that way we have RX going to TX and TX going to RX on this converter. So at the media converter out the sign there, we hooked the red cable up to the TX. So it needs to go to the RX on this side. And then we'll get the black up to the other one. So again, we're going RX to TX and RX to TX. Once we've got that connected, we can go ahead and power up the media converter. So we'll take the power, the wall pack transformer, and plug that into an outlet. We now have power to the fiber media converter. And you'll notice we got a power light, we got an FD light, but those are the only two lights we've got on. The reason that we don't have anything else is because we need to get our Ethernet jack or Ethernet cable plugged into the Ethernet jack on the fiber media converter, and then the other end of the cable plugged into a network jack. That's important that the network jack be connected to the internet because in order for the display to download its messages, it needs to be able to reach out through the internet to the Venus Control Suite cloud to download those messages. This is different than how we previously had the signs hooked up because we now have to have that internet access as opposed to a direct sign to computer connection. So I'm going to go ahead and get this cable plugged into the network, and then we'll check those lights and verify our boot sequence. All right, we've got our jack plugged in. We can see that we've got our some lights here flickering now. Our link lights are active. That's a good sign. All of the lights are actually on and working properly. So now we should be good to hook up the display, power up the display, and check the boot sequence to make sure it's pulling an IP address from our network. As we can see, the sign is now going through its boot sequence. In a second, we should see an IP address on the display of 10.1.12.60. That shows that the display is connected to the network. It has pulled an IP address from the network, and we should be able to communicate using the Venus Control Suite software on our computer.